Good morning, children. Today we are going to learn our third lesson, that is the mice and elephant. What is the lesson name? The mice and the elephants. Once upon a time, there was a king who lived in a fine stone palace. After many years, the king grew old and died. Once upon a time means many years ago, a king lived in a fine stone palace. Means such a huge palace. It was made with a stone. And after some years, the king grew old. He became old and he died. Everyone left the palace. The people who were living in the palace, everyone left the palace. Why did they left? Because there was no king and no one is there to look after the palace and the people. So they left. Slowly the walls fell down and soon only the floors were left. Slowly the walls of the palace fell down. They all fell down, means the palace also became, a palace also vanished. And soon only the floors were left. Only the floors, like ground and other things left. Now in the cracks of the floors lived hundreds of mice. Now in the cracks of the floors, when no one is living there, no humans are living in the palace, then the mice came and they started living there. Hundreds of mice were living together. They lived with their sons and grandsons, their grandfathers and their grandmothers. And they were all very comfortable. They lived with their grandsons, sons, grandparents. And they all were living happily and comfortable. They had everything what they wanted. They had everything in the palace. So they were very comfortable. They played games and had festivals and weddings, dramas, feasts. They were all very happy and they played games. Mice were playing games and they had festival. They celebrated the festival and they made the wedding. They enjoyed the wedding over there and they enjoyed dramas. Feast means a function, party, what we say that. They had very yummy food. And then they were all happy. They all were living very happy. Near their palace was a large lake. One day in a hot weather, the elephant king came to drink water with his herd. Then where they were living, near that palace, there was a large lake. There was a large lake and one day in a hot weather. It was a summer season, so obviously the weather will be hot. Then the elephant was the king and he came with his herd to drink water, means his group of other animals. The whole herd walked all over the floor of the palace. Then all the elephants walk over the floors of palace. Means they entered into the palace, they walked around the palace, they killed many of the mice. Then they knowingly, they killed many of the mice because they could not see the mice which were on their feet, under their feet. The mice were very sad. They held a meeting. When elephants stamped on them and many mice were killed, then remaining mice became very sad and they held a meeting of all the mice. These elephants will kill us all, they agreed. What shall we do? Then in meeting they said that these elephants are not going to leave us. They are going to kill all of us. What to do? They cried. And then what shall we do? They cried. Some of mice went to the elephants. They said, "Oh friend, we live palace floors. If you walk over the floors on the way to the lake, you will kill us. Please go along another path. One day we may help you." Then some of the mice went to the elephants and they said, Oh my friends, please, we live on the floors of palace. If you walk on the floors of the palace, you will kill us. you will kill us. So please, we request you, take another path to go to the lake. Instead of floors of palace, please take another path of the lake, another path to go to the lake. The elephant king and his herd listened to the mice, and they agreed to use another path. And also the mice promised them, one day we may help you. So please, you leave us and take another path. And the elephant king and his herd listened to them. They listened to them and they agreed to take another path. Now one day, the elephant king and his herd were trapped in the forest by some hunters. Now one day, what happened? Elephant king and his herd, they all were caught by the hunters. They were tied up with ropes. Luckily, one of the elephants was not trapped. And in the herd, luckily one elephant was not trapped, means he was not caught by the hunters. He ran through the forest and called the mice. He ran around the forest and called for the mice. He called for the mice. Oh, friend mice, please come. We all are in the trouble. Please come and help us. Hundreds of them came to help the elephants. They bit the ropes and last the elephants were free. And hundreds of mice came to them. And they all helped the elephants by biting the rope. When they bited them, the elephants became free. And the elephants thanked the mice and they remembered the old saying, make friends, always make friends, however strong or weak. Then all the elephants thanked to the mice. Thank you so much, you saved our lives. And they all remembered the one saying, that is, make friends, make always friends, however whether they are strong or they are weak. Because we know, we can't say that only the strong person can help us. Even weaker person can use his brain and help us. The strong person can use his strength. He can use his strength. But the weak person, he can use his brain and help us. So don't underestimate anyone. So don't underestimate anyone. Make friends, whether they are strong or whether they are weak. So children, we will continue in the next class. Till then, take care.